here, we get to watch Mulan.
After we waited since March.
27.
Anyway, so we got it on Disney Plus. We did have to pay that extra $30 premium, which to us seemed very worth it because that's about how much we spent at the movie theater anyway. Probably a little bit cheaper. But it's actually really good because we get to be in the comfort of our own home, get to be in comfy clothes, get to eat our own snacks, get to eat chips and junk food and get up anytime that we want.
Relax and be as loud as you want.
Yes,
so
me and Dylan get super excited. It's a good thing this doesn't have the Mulan songs from the original because we would be belting out.
Yeah.
What's that song? No.
Oh, I'll make a man.
I'll make a man out of you. Yes, we love that song, so we're super sad that's not going to be in the movie, but we're still very excited.
Real quick, before we move into the theater, what are you guys excited for? What are you guys looking forward to in the movie?
Just to see what Disney has to put on it, the twist, and you know, mostly being based on that Chinese culture than the actual animated film.
For me, I don't really know because there's no songs, there's no Mushu, there's no Shang. I don't know what to expect for this one.
It's so very different. Yeah.
The Dragon Psychic isn't here. I was really looking forward to see that, but I guess since he's not here, scenes I'm excited for is just really the fighting scene. Based off on the trailer, fighting scenes or action scenes seem to be great. I'm excited to see the fighting scene, so that's what I'm looking forward to.
Yeah. Let's get to it. Let's go to the snack area
though. Oh, you did it.
I don't need you. I'm like Mulan. Popcorn stuff. We bought the movie theater popcorn and some nacho cheddar. I don't really like the stuff too much, but we're gonna add some because we're going all out. I love butter. And I guess because I just don't like that it sits right on top. I like it to mix. Best to my ability. Excited for popcorn.
Mine's much more simpler. It's just, let's go. Movie time.
Your job is to bring honor to the family. Do you think you can do that?
It is my duty.
Alright, so we just got finished watching the live action remake of Mulan, and
I'm tired. I was falling asleep. No, just kidding.
Overall, I want to say it was a really good movie. I liked it. I enjoyed it. It was fun. Now, before any of that, I'm just kind of getting tired of all these anti-everything and people having to make everything a bad thing. And I know right now going on, there's a boycott Mulan hashtag, you know, involvement. And
there's a lot of political stuff just for a single movie that's released.
And it's like, why can't we cut out the political crap watch our movies, you know, forget about the world.
That's what movies are for. They're supposed to take you into a cinematic universe, you know?
Yeah, forget about what's going on outside. I also hate that, you know, because of all this and people changing their views, which, you know, we used to be a lot more freer, I guess. I don't even know how to explain it. Disney has changed their movies as well for culture appropriation. You know, that's why Mushu is not in the movie, because I guess, I mean,
he was taken in the wrong way, the wrong light for the animated version. He seems more like the comedic relief instead of some sort of power to move on.
Anyway, we understand protecting, you know, cultures and not making fun of other cultures or anything like that. Honestly, I would not get upset if some Hispanic movie was made and, you know, things were changed differently and not following our cultural stuff. Because, you know, at the end of the day, it's just a movie. But anyway, besides all the changes, let's talk about what we like.
Okay. I guess I'll start for what we like. There was a lot of scenes in Mulan, the remake, that were just so visually pleasing. I can think of, and the costumes were great. Everything looked so amazing and detailed, and yeah, I guess that's what I like the most.
The fighting scene was alright, not so much for what I expected. I do like the way they move the swords and use the swords. They're training, I mean, I like all of that. They're training and swords and their fighting styles.
Overall, it was pretty much the same movie from the animation, besides like the
comedic, the singing parts,
the songs. So it's a very good movie. I guess that leads into the dislikes.
Right.
There was a lot of dislikes, at least personally, to me, especially not including the songs. Hello, like, I expect a Disney movie to sing and laugh and sing my heart out.
This movie was very, very serious. I mean, is a very serious movie.
Yeah.
Not much comedy into it.
To me, a couple laughs here and there, but nothing big.
To me, I think personally, I know there's some like other like businesses that can make their own versions of these movies. Like, I know there was a Little Mermaid, I think, that came out a long time ago. But this Mulan, it kind of didn't feel like Disney to me, honestly. There was, I don't know how to explain it, but the songs and the comedic relief of Mushu, that sidekick, you know, it just felt very different.
I thought it did feel like a Disney movie. I liked it. I enjoyed it. But I didn't like that it was dragged in a couple parts. So some parts felt really slow and like, it's like, when are we getting there? And then some parts felt really fast, like it was rushing through the movie. It's like the timing was on and off, on and off, on and off.
I have one more thing to add to this. Personally, I can't remember their names right now, but the three sidekicks along with Mulan, the human versions.
Cricket.
Well, they were very rushed to me. Like, they had more screen time in the animated movie, and they felt more important in the animated movie.
These just feel like
completely side characters, not even like, oh yeah, I remember this guy or not. But that was kind of frustrating to me, because, yeah.
So for me, I really just disliked the idea. I mean, I was really looking forward to seeing Mulan and the bad chick kind of get into it and into a great battle scene. And I didn't see that, and that was kind of disappointing. Really, that would have been cool to see two big powers like that.
So, what do we rate it? I want to say I rate it, not comparing it to the animated film, I would definitely give it like a 8 out of 10.
I stay with you, 8 out of 10 as well.
I didn't know we were not comparing it, but I would say 7 out of 10.
It's a movie that, honestly, I really enjoyed watching right now, but will I watch it again? Honestly, probably not until like my next kid needs to watch it.
We'll pay $30, so we'll be watching it every night.
Honestly, I was a little disappointed, not a lot, but it's just my personal preference, because Mulan is in my top 3 favorite Disney movies of all time. I love Mulan, and and that's why I was so excited when I heard it was coming out on my birthday. It just felt so lucky to me, and I'm like,
yeah, it's like it's a love and hate relationship with the movie. Like, it goes both ways. But I mean, I definitely say if you're a Disney fan, definitely get the, you know, the subscription and pay $30. Again, it's something to enjoy while we're in quarantine or closed up. If not, it comes out in December for everybody on Disney Plus, so you don't have to pay for it.
Yeah.
Wait for December. So there you have it in our movie review from the Chigoyas.
And then our next movie will hopefully be, I think, it's The Conjuring. I'm not sure. I haven't looked at all these crazy movie releases because they're always changing this year.
Always like half online, half in theaters. So
Conjuring is gonna be so great, especially now that like Halloween time is coming up, so definitely awesome.
So thanks for watching. Don't forget to hit like and subscribe. Bye.